Aloo is a starch, it's a complex carbohydrate, you shouldn't have it. But just look at the story of aloo. Aloo's discovered in South America after Columbus. They discover first the sweet potato in Peru, and then they discover what we call the aloo. It's brought to India by colonialists and not planted. It's sort of garden farming, not planted in many parts of India till the 18th or 19th century. And yet, can you actually think of Indian food without potatoes? It's just a sort of natural affinity India has with the aloo. In India, we say that somebody's like an aloo. You can fit it with anything because you can cook aloo with pretty much anything. Cook it with meat, cook it with vegetables, cook it as chips, cook it in a cutlet, in a tikki. So just the incredible resourcefulness of anybody who cooks with an aloo has always struck me as being extraordinary. But there is one other side to it, and something that worries me, that in America or in England, if you were to go anywhere in the world, really, in the Western world, certainly, if you were to go to a shop and you were to try and buy aloos, potatoes will almost always be sold by variety. If nothing else, there'll be a distinction between floury potatoes and waxy potatoes. And people will say, you make chips with this, you make baked potatoes with this, you make mash with this. India's like the only country where nobody, not even the farmers who grow them, know the difference between various breeds of aloo. You go to a sabzi wala and you say, mujhe aloo de do. He'll give you whatever he has. Often they will be mixed. It won't even be one lot, which means that while aloo is okay for us for using as tikkis or sabzi or something, you can't really make something like, say, French fries with aloo, because very often there's too much sugar in Indian potatoes. So that's the paradox for me of the Indian love affair with the potato. Yeah. We love it, but we don't understand.